Hello there. It's me, Molly, from the fabrication department. I am hanging out in my basement studio, and I want to tell you about a really easy thing that you can make at home that will help you give better presentations, have more hands-on demonstrations, if that makes sense for what you're doing, to showcase physical models, just to mix things up a bit now that we're all learning how to interact virtually. So this is borrowing from Tom Oliphant's furniture design class. Everyone was tasked with making a hands-free phone holding device that will give more flexibility when presenting work. Here's his prototype idea. It's a phone, a rubber band, and a jar of dried beans or whatever you got. I'm a big popcorn fan, so shout out to popcorn. And then you can use this on your desk or wherever makes sense to get a different angle in your Zoom meeting. So you can pair this up with your laptop as well so that you can have a couple different ways connecting to Zoom that'll help you better showcase what you're doing. I will take some pictures of what's currently holding my phone, but it does give me a lot of flexibility so I can raise and lower it. I can swivel it. Ooh, give a little shop tour. It's not as clean as I meant it to be. Oh, there's me trying to duck out of the frame. Ha! There's my drawers of craft supplies and tools and other things. I can use this to give some hands-on sort of demonstration, if that makes sense. So, oh, there's my nacho plate up there. And then I just have my saw set up. I can show hands-on sewing stuff in my sewing corner over there. The point is, we all need to be embracing technology and figuring out how to better showcase ourselves and our work and promote better learning outcomes. And it can be as simple as a rubber band and a spoon and some dried beans, but it's really helpful. And I want to encourage everyone to make your own little device like this to try out. And now I'll take some pictures of what is holding this phone up. Here is a closer look at what was holding up my phone when I made that video. Again, a sturdy rubber band is a very helpful tool. So I just cut a piece of wood into three different parts, drilled some holes, put some bolts and wing nuts in there, and now I have a really nice adjustable phone holder. And then if you follow it down, it is connected to a swivel chair. So that gives it another dimension of ease when adjusting it. Gives me a lot of versatility, and it was really straightforward to make. So following that down again, you can see it's connected to the chair with some spring clamps, which are a really quick and easy way to make a connection that's easily adjustable, that doesn't damage the chair in any way. And then I also attached this board to the chair, so I just used some plumber strap, which is just a little strip of metal that has some holes in it. So I drilled that into the wood, so that is holding that board on the chair. And then I can put my laptop there. So if you're having a coffee meeting with me or you invite me to happy hour, this is what my setup looks like. Last week I had my laptop just sitting on this chair without that board, and it was sliding all around because the board or the chair is an organic shape. So anytime I tried to type anything on my computer, it would move around. So we'll try this out this week and see how it goes. And I'll also start experimenting more with this camera setup, see how it works when I'm trying to do hands-on demonstrations or trying to do presentations. I'm looking forward to seeing how it goes, and I will improve it along the way. And I'm also looking forward to seeing what you come up with.